Did you know that some of the greatest thinkers in history had one common ritual? And that was a daily writing and journaling practice. So I have been reviewing my journals that I've kept for the last decade. I've been reviewing my journals from 2010 all the way through to the end of 2019. And I wanted to share some of that journey with you and the lessons that I've learned along the way. One of the things that I also invite you into as a practice as we start a new decade is journaling, making it a ritual. And actually, I've got an amazing self-discovery process and journaling experience coming out as my next book that I can't wait to share with you. And speaking of books, I've written a few of them this decade. In my latest book, The Rituals, there is a beautiful practice called Museum of You on page 118 that talks about documenting your life so that you can go back and you can glean the lessons and the wisdom and find the gold along the way that you get to mine and bring into your life moving forward. So The Rituals is the latest book. I've written some other books in the last decade. This is my first one, She Takes on the World. This was also the website that I ran for more than a decade. This girl sitting on top of the world. So super grateful for all the work that she put in. The next book, The Conquer Kit. This was like a game changer for me and my business. Conquer Your Year. So much has happened in the last decade. And of all the books I've written, this one is probably the most profound in my life. And it takes me from 2009 up until 2016. And 10 years ago, my life was very different. I was living in a small apartment. I was living in a small city in Canada and just holding such a grand vision in my heart for the decade ahead, where I was gonna build a business and I was gonna travel to 100 countries. And I did all of those things. So anyway, going back to 2010, I was writing about being recognized on the Forbes list for top career sites for women. And I was given an award for America's Most Inspiring Young Women by Arianna Huffington and the former First Lady of the UK, Sarah Brown. And I wrote about really feeling like I didn't belong because I felt like I couldn't afford to be in a hotel in New York City, and leaving that experience and making a commitment to myself that I was going to really look deeper at my unworthiness and where it was holding me back in my life before I was about to embark on building my blog, She Takes on the World, into its own business. Going into 2011, I won an Emmy in 2011. Where is it? 2011, I won an Emmy. This changed my life. This changed a lot of things in my life. I also mentored entrepreneurs at the White House that year, and I was like, what? How is this my life? And I was at the same time feeling like, what if what I create next doesn't match, doesn't compare. So what if I create a project and it doesn't win any awards? I've been winning all these awards and getting recognized. What if I've reached my peak in my early 20s? And I used to ask myself those questions. And then I started to do a lot of training in meditation and different modalities. And I really started to step into a place of surrender and step into a place of recognizing my inherent worth and my power to create the life that I most desired. After getting the book deal and having the Conquer Club launch go really, really well, I decided to put that on hold, to put the personal brand on hold for a little while. And actually, it stayed on hold for quite a few years. I think it's a good lesson in honoring what's present and what's going really well while still working on and holding the bigger vision, knowing that it will be something that you can circle back to and continue to circle back to. So I used to ask myself and check in, is now the right time to switch gears? And everything was growing so fast at She Takes on the World and with the Conquer Club and with the Conquer book series that I wanted to focus on that. And in focusing on that, it created so much abundance in my life. It created wealth. It allowed me to build a really successful brand. And I was able to take that and start to invest in other things that I wanted to do, but that took a little bit of time. So in 2015, I started to transition and move to the US. And even though I was really excited about my move and getting my green card and getting to come to first New York and then Los Angeles, there was also a deep pain in that. I felt like a part of me was dying and there was a lot of grief. This is one that I wrote at the halfway point. I said, we are halfway through the decade. Oh my God, it's been an amazing 5 years and I wonder what's going to happen between now and 2020. So what have I learned so far? It's all within you. I think I knew this from that time that I was in the hospital. I'd been in the hospital when I was a child for a little bit. Even when you seek healers, you seek outside of yourself. You know, your body knows, your heart knows. The signs are always subtle. Your life usually whispers at you before it screams. Continue to trust the whispers. Just fucking do it. As the Balinese healer said. I don't know if the Balinese healer really said just fucking do it, but that's what's written here. People told me to work 3 years before starting a business. They told me to wait 10 years to write a book because I needed more life experience. What? Why? Start. Just do it. Natalie, keep on doing it. Yes, that is a note to future me. So it's so cool to get to look back and read some of those. And then of course, what unfolded over these past 5 years as I've created this life here in Los Angeles and found what I feel is my soul family. I have the most beautiful friends here. I'm in an incredible relationship and all around me are dreams that I once dreamed. And all of that feels so good. And it's because I document everything. It's because I document my life and my dreams that I'm able to look back and reflect on exactly where I was at the time and the lessons I was learning and then use all of those in my life as I move forward. I invite you to take a look back. And Steve Jobs said it's only in looking back that we can connect all the dots. And it's because I document things that I can look back and I can connect the dots. I can see why things happened a certain way. And I can see the perfection in how they unfolded. And when I can see that, and I invite you to step into that and be able to reflect and look back and read your journals, because when we do that and we can connect those dots, it allows us to give ourselves evidence of what's possible. And it's in giving ourselves evidence that we can be even more confident about where we're going. Like at this point in my life, if I'm taking a risk or I'm doing something a little differently, I can look back and I can see points in my life where I took the risk, where I invested a huge amount of money and it did pay off. And I've always been supported. I've always been taken care of since starting my business and since pursuing my dreams. And I have that as hard evidence in my life because of the way that I document things. So happy new year and let's make this an incredible decade ahead.